Conrad Black's rise as a media tycoon began in the 1960s, when he started buying up small Canadian newspapers. By the 1990s, he was in charge of an empire that spanned Europe, the United States and beyond, owning some of the world's most prestigious titles, amongst them Chicago's Sun Times, the Jerusalem Post, and the UK's Daily Telegraph. But his fall from grace was as dramatic as his rise. In November 2003, he was forced to resign as the chief executive of Hollinger International, accused by the board of directors of siphoning off millions of dollars of cash into his own pockets. By August 2005, the tale begins to unravel. The Securities and Exchange Commission charges Black and three of his associates with fraud, obstruction of justice, and racketeering. By December 2007, his media empire is on his knees, and so it seems is his reputation. Lord Conrad Black is acquitted of many of the charges of which he's been accused, but convicted on several counts, and so sentenced to 6.5 years in prison. Conrad Black has always maintained his innocence, and many of those remaining charges were overturned by the Supreme Court. Richard Quest, CNN, London.